number. You can bring out the page number, third, the last para. So where it is known as Samadhi Pada and Sadhana Pada, two chapters for two types of people. Oh, looking, both you are looking beautiful, good. So you had two vaccinations?
Yes.
Okay, and you have one. So, I have been telling it again and again that yoga, or which I say, yoga includes all the practices of mindfulness, meditation, asana, pranayama, mantra, and there are 52 groups of practices. And every group has hundreds of practices. Like one group is asana. So you have more than 300 to 400 postures. So that yoga aims at, what it aims at? I always say that, to become a good person. Are you a good person? Yes. So, well, if you are a good person, it means in yoga we have a discipline in our life. Do you have a discipline in your life? Good. You wake up in the morning and keep lying on the bed? No. Good, Avery. And what about you, Hayden?
My computer's doing really weird right now. What did you say?
When you wake up in the morning and keep lying on the bed, it makes difficult for you to get out of the bed. You talk to your dad and dad pushes you. No, you have to do this thing and you get upset. No. Very good, Avery. So what happened?
Well, everything's... Yeah.
So now I was asking you, when you wake up in the morning and you keep lying on the bed, your mind says no.
Yeah, I do that.
Mind says no, let me lie down one more hour. That is where the yoga comes. Yoga understands how to how to change that laziness, how to change anxiety. How to
conflict. Internet's cutting out really bad, so I'm gonna try and
try. Keep trying. That's how we become a good person. So if there is an absence of anxiety, upset, laziness, or you can say the dullness, any sense of anxiousness, that is what yoga says, that you become a good person in your life. But that is only the first step. Then what happens in the second step? We become a good person. Good person means I good person to myself. First, you become a good person to yourself. Good person to yourself means internally, I experience calmness, peace, joy all the time, 24/7. So that very process is known as awakening. Then, now comes how to become that good person. To summarize, to bring an end to the suffering in my life. Everyone suffers in one way or the other. So if we bring an end to the suffering and we live in permanent peace and happiness, we have completed the journey of yoga. I was teaching small kids in New Jersey. Kids mean they are in kindergarten, maybe 7 to 10 years of old. So I said, who wants to be a good person? Everyone raised their hand. Then I said, how many of you, when your mom wakes you up in the morning to go to school and you do not wake up, you wake up but you keep lying on the bed? So again, 10 people raised their hand. I said, very good. So are you a good person or not? No, I'm not a good person. I said, do you want to know? Do you want to remove that laziness? Yes. So simple. When we discipline our life, discipline for what? To become a good person to myself. You need not to show to anyone in the world. So I said, okay, I will give you a practice. So they were small kids, very kindergarten. So I gave them 5 to 7 minutes of the practice, and majority of those kids started snoring. They fall into deep sleep. And after they woke up, they said, oh, I feel so good. I said, if you do the practice before going to sleep, so you will go into a sound sleep, then there will be no problem of laziness in the morning. So our goal is to become a good person inside. You become a good person to yourself first. And if you are good to yourself, you are good to everyone. Understood. Now come to the second part. Who can tread the path of yoga? So our master says, a seeker. Who is a seeker? And who is a seeker now? We should understand who is a seeker. So, who can drive the car on a road? Who has a driving license? Who has a driving license? Who knows the rules of the road and skills of driving? So who is a seeker? Who knows, who has the right knowledge about yoga and who continues to practice? So if we do not practice, nothing will happen. We don't become a seeker. So now there are two types of seeker. The highest seeker, Helen has gone, she will appear again, no problem. So who is the highest seeker? Who is the highest seeker? Who is committed? Who follows the discipline? 24/7, whose mind is clear, whose mind is pure, he becomes or she becomes a seeker. First type of the seeker, the middle level of a seeker, they have a lot of challenges, maybe anxiousness, laziness, dullness, reaction, anger, hesitation. So they need to work on these challenges. When they work on these challenges by disciplining the mind, they also become a seeker. No one is left in yoga. We may not complain that I'm not a seeker, that's why I cannot do the practice. If you are not a seeker, Master says, learn, 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 receive the knowledge and start doing the practice, you become a seeker. Eden has returned, right? Again, freezed. Not my mistake, your problem of internet. So that is what? So once we are a seeker, then we get the right knowledge, we have a right mental state, we have a willingness to practice, the life changes, we become a good person. Casey likes it, you know, when I start talking about becoming a good person. We never thought that yoga teaches this. So when I teach kids like you, I always say, be a good person to yourself. Find out what are the challenges that you have. Laziness, we can remove the laziness. You don't get a sleep, we will help you to go into a deeper sleep. You do not understand, we will sharpen your mind to understand, provided you follow the discipline. So, our masters, how many masters we have? We have more than 3,000 masters for the period of 10,000 years old. And the knowledge is already in the books. So we have to learn each and every principle. We have to understand the principle and the practices. And when we do the practice, the life changes. So that is the first point I wanted to make. And now, I talked about, everyone has some form of anxiety, anger, duality, conflict, being upset, why it happens. Do you want anxiety and depression in your life? No, I don't want, but they enter into our life. Do I want to be angry? No, but anger happens. Why we are sometimes very happy, other time upset, still other times we get angry. Why it happens? Do you have any answer?
Because we're in our false natures?
Yes, that is the first answer. It's a wonderful, I like it. Every you still remember all those things. Yes, by the false nature. So now we are understanding a little deeper because of the three qualities that is present in the body, mind, intellect, ego, that causes the problems and challenges in our life. Or we can say the entire world consists of these three qualities. And these three qualities cannot be seen, but its symptoms can be felt. Now I make a big face, so obviously I'm in stress. So that's how I know the symptoms. Through the symptoms, we can understand these three qualities. So these qualities are also, how these qualities are intertwined. They are intertwined like a thread. Have you seen the thread? You have very thin cotton lining. And many linings are intertwined, and that is known as the thread. Even you have a very thin thread, it contains many linings of the cotton. So what we say, the three linings are the three qualities. Now you are okay, Hayden? Oh, now you hear me. Good.
There was a bug on my desk, and I kept trying to smash it, and it ran away just before I got it. And so I had to, like, go onto the floor and find it again, and, like, it was a whole process. But I'm good.
Oh, good, good, good. If the bug interrupts you again, let me know.
So I got it. I already, it's done. It's over. Its life has ended.
Good. Good. So three qualities. So these three qualities are known as satoguna, rajoguna, and tamoguna. So you can also write on your, so sattva guna is the one, rajas guna is the second, and tamas guna is the third. So first, understand these names and then we will understand their qualities. How, what satoguna does, what rajas guna does, what tamas guna does. You are not at all responsible for anything. Provided you are following the path of yoga, that is conditional. So now understand what is satoguna. So you write satoguna and in the same line, hyphen and write down knowledge, happiness. Satoguna causes knowledge, happiness. Rajoguna, rajas guna, hyphen, activity, strong likes and dislikes. And tamas guna, hyphen, what is tamas guna? The quality of the tamas guna is inertness. It acts like a matter and it opposes knowledge. So now understand this three guna, satas guna. When you receive the knowledge from anywhere, either by studying the books or by the teacher like me, and your mind is totally focused in learning, and you are learning in a joy, then what happens? In your mind, the satoguna is active. Did you understand that? And if there are strong likes and dislikes, the mind is constantly wandering. Mind is not able to pay attention. Oh, anyhow, let us learn from this beard guy. He has fixed the time, but mind is somewhere else. That is caused by the rajas guna in the mind. And you are learning, but you fall sleepy, dullness is there, the mind acts like a matter. You know, the smartphone is also present nearby you. They are not listening. What I'm saying, they are not listening. So when the mind becomes like a matter, inert, and it opposes the knowledge, it is tamas guna. Anger, tamas guna. Reaction, tamas guna. Mind is constantly wandering, rajas guna. Mind is focused and enjoys what one is doing. You are learning, you enjoy learning. You are eating, you enjoy eating. Did you understand? The mind contains these three gunas. Clear? Now, another point. This mind is 90%. It's an example. 90% it is seeking knowledge and happiness. Understand, this is also everyone's mind. Mind is 90% satoguna. It means it is constantly seeking knowledge and happiness. You are learning from me not to get more stress. You are eating not to have a stress. You are sleeping to avoid stress. So satoguna is 90, mind is 90% satoguna. It is seeking knowledge and happiness. Clear? Now see that it is in the same mind you have a, because I told you the satoguna, the mind is made up of three gunas. And if the mind is made up of three gunas, 90% is satoguna, 7% is rajoguna, 3% is tamoguna. So go back to the qualities of tamoguna. Why 3% is there? Why shouldn't I remove all the entire tamoguna? No, it is not possible. 3%. They are in percentage. When the mind drops into tamoguna, it gives you a sound sleep. That is why tamoguna is required. Now, yesterday we were eating pizza. So you need a bread. You need the toppings. Huh? You need the olives. And lot of other stuff. Same thing, the mind is made up of three guna. All the three gunas are required. Clear? So tamoguna helps you to sleep deeply. And tamoguna also brings the dullness, laziness. You wake up, oh, my mind doesn't, you know, want me to get out of the bed. That is dangerous. That is negative. So what is positive in tamoguna? It helps you to sleep deeply. What is negative in tamoguna? It causes laziness, dullness. It rejects the right knowledge. What is right and good, it rejects. Sometimes we do it, you know, sometimes. No, Dad, I don't want to listen to you. No, I'm okay. What I'm doing is right. Without understanding, we oppose. That is tamoguna. Did it happen to you, Hayden, sometime? Yes, so it is because of the tamoguna. And many people tell me that they have a disturbed sleep, they have not slept for many years. That is due to rajoguna. Negative part. And what is positive part of rajoguna? If your mind is not alert and attentive at this time, then you will not receive the knowledge. So rajoguna keeps the mind active. But if you become overactive, hyperactive, that is a problem. Huh? Did you understand that? And the satoguna always is good. Always good. It is 90% natural by default. What I said, satoguna is present in the mind 90% by default. 7% by default, rajasguna. 3% by default, tamoguna. Now I will give you a puzzle and you answer. What is the puzzle? Puzzle is, if rajas guna is 90%, what will happen to your life? Tell me. What will happen to your life? Rajas guna, look at the quality of rajas guna. Activity. Strong likes and dislikes. Now you wake up in the morning, you have strong likes and dislikes. You like mom more than your dad. you have strong likes and dislikes, whatever your mom and dad says, you say, no, I'm okay, don't tell me. So your mind is always active. Even you are lying in the bed and the mind is active, super active. You cannot get into sleep. You wake up with the hangovers. See that? Have you seen some people fidgeting? Huh? Maybe in your family. They are sitting on the couch and they started singing with their feet. Rajas Guna. That is how I observe people based on this knowledge. I have a lot of private lessons. You know, even the younger people like you, of your age, they are coming to me for private lessons. So I observe them, I check them. You have a shallow breathing into the chest, Rajoguna. People have the tendency. Huh? To move and lift their shoulders. People have the tendency to move their hands and fingers even while listening. Aiden, are you listening? People also have the same habit of, when I say close their eyes and they keep their one eyes open. Rajas Guna. So because of the Rajas Guna, the mind is hyperactive and it is not able to focus. It is not attentive. So if the 90% mind lives with the 90% of Rajas Guna, if the mind lives 90% with the Rajas Guna, that person is known as crazy. Real terms, crazy. Sometimes we say with the casually, no, really crazy guy. So why he or she is crazy? Because of these three qualities. So if I switch on, if you know the method how to switch on Rajas Guna from 90% to only 7%, you are free. Did you understand? And now tell me what will happen if Tamas Guna is 90% and Sattva Guna is only 3%.
You'll be very lazy.
Very lazy. Obsession will be there. And that person always opposes the right, what is right and good. They all simply oppose. Why are you taking drugs? Come on, take the drugs and I will tell you, you are going into heaven, opposing the knowledge. You oppose the right knowledge. Look at it. So they get obsessed with it. Obsession leads to addiction. And then they have a lot of problems in their life. See? So Tamas Guna is 90%. That makes your life crazy. You may be successful. You are always ready to commit crime. You are always ready to do violence. Tamas Guna. So now understand, every person is very good from their heart and the head. But what happens because of the disturbances in these three qualities, they outwardly they become bad, but the real self is still very good, good inside. Are you understanding? Are you getting it, both of you? So every person is very good. Excellent people. Human being by default. Why they are good people? Because Sattva Guna by default is 90%. But because of misunderstanding, you rightly said, because of false notion, I increase either the Rajoguna or the Tamoguna. Are you getting it? Are you understanding that? So once we increase this Rajas and Tamoguna, then our life becomes miserable. What is this misery? Her is misery. Aaron, you are thinking, you told me you think very fast. I had a wonderful meeting with both of you yesterday. Allow the brain to work fast. Tell me the answer. See that? So understand, every person is a wonderful person, the human being.
My internet is so bad, it keeps working for like a few minutes and then it goes really downhill.
Maybe internet is working in Rajas Guna. It goes away. So, you are the main, yes. So your internet is influenced by Rajas Guna. That is why it is going, coming, hyperactive. So did you understand the three gunas? Now, from that point of view, if you understand yoga means that we should apply the knowledge and the practices by which we increase sato guna by 90%. Why 90%? 99%. So when you are in 99%, then what happens? Rajas and tamas guna do not interfere in your life. What are the qualities of sato guna? Knowledge and happiness. So then what happens? You constantly live in joy, in knowledge, in peace, in calmness. Did you get it? Yes. So these three qualities are there. Did you understand? We will understand a little bit more about the sato guna. Three gunas are there. We will understand by, you can also keep a note. I'm putting it on the chat. Sato guna. Let us understand first the sato guna. What is satoguna? Is the spiritual quality. Means it is the quality of the real self. Second part, when the satoguna is more than rajas and tamas guna. Means satoguna is dominant. A person has inherent desire to be good, caring, good and caring. So if you are not good in caring, it is not your responsibility. Start working on the mind. Increase sato guna. And you will have a natural quality. Did you understand? So there is a resolute constancy of the mind and the senses. Means what? It means whatever your senses perceives the world, your eyes, ears, they remain calm. They don't get agitated. Got it? When sato guna is prevalent, means dominant, the light of wisdom shines through the individual. What it means? Then you remain totally full with the knowledge and happiness. Even if someone says, whatever you are doing, you don't get upset. Oh, you said, okay, this guy has a rajas guna, let me answer with the sato guna. Do you see that? When sattvic intellect clearly understand the difference between desirable and undesirable, undutiful and the dutiful action. Very important at this age. You both are good kids. So what it means? It means that it means that the person person knows clearly what is right and good, and what you like and what is pleasant to you. What is the meaning? So, because of the knowledge and the happiness, your mind always thinks and follows what is right and good. Every come here, your mom says, so you go there, you don't get upset. You go to your mom and then say, Mom, is it possible you spare 1 hour? I'm doing my homework and then I will come back to you. And if you are in Rajoguna, then what will happen? Mom, why you are disturbing me? I'm doing my homework. Did it happen sometime? So this is the quality of the Satoguna, instantly. So this means that I'm dutiful. I'm responsible for my parents. I'm responsible for my friends. I'm responsible for my siblings. So that is why I respond dutifully. I do not respond by reaction. Did you get it? Satoguna. Now another part is also very important. When Satoguna is dominant, a person does his or her work as a duty. What is your duty in the family? Tell me. Living in a family, I should maintain the harmony. No backbiting, no reaction. Parents, they are older, so I should respect them. I should respect the older sibling, and I should care the younger sibling. My duty. This is our duty. I should be dutiful as far as the homework is concerned. When I go to school, like this. Oh, I'm free. Mom, can I participate in cooking? Let me help you. So that is also my duty. That is the quality of a Satoguna. See that? So two things. When Satoguna is dominant, I am always doing my duty, my work. The moment you are present and I started teaching, not beating about the bush, okay, how are you? Then I sleep. And then after 5 minutes, and I say, okay, you are there, so I don't waste time. Why should I waste your time? Even when I'm a teacher, no. When I'm doing on my own, then I don't waste even a single minute. Why? Because it is my duty. It is my responsibility. Are you girls responsible? Means Satoguna, knowledge, I want to receive the knowledge, I am focused, I pay attention. So an action is done with a calm understanding and the person is free from doubt. There is no doubt. When Sato is dominant, a person pays homage to divine and the spiritual values. Understood that part? Now let us understand a little bit of Rajas Guna. But the Rajas Guna is, it has good and bad both. So, what we are talking, do you remember? Three qualities in the mind. So no one is responsible for doing right and wrong thing. It is because if the mind lives in Satoguna, then you start becoming a good person. And if it is not living, we have to make it happen. That is what the yoga is. Very good, Hayden. Now, your internet connection is playing with the Rajoguna. So no worries. You are disconnected, connect it again. So Rajas Guna is an active quality. Active. So it leads to passion and desire. If the desire is right, have a passion for that desire and achieve it. Do you have a passion to become a good batter and the best person in the world? Follow the path of yoga. The journey is not too far. But it has a negative quality also. If you are not attentive, it causes greed, hyperactivity, restlessness, attachment. We become too much selfish. So Rajas Guna has a positive quality. Rajas Guna has a negative quality. So we have to balance. You like a particular food, you are on a dining table, and now you are eating, you overeat because of Rajoguna. And that is what we say, the binge eating, overeating, obese, and obese people have challenges in their life. What is the positive quality of Rajoguna? Enthusiasm. Interest. You are passionate about what you are doing. You are passionate about, no, I will commit. I'm committing. I will do it. Did you understand? So Rajas Guna has the positive and the negative qualities. If you lose the track, it will put you into the problems. That is why we have suffering. So if we bring the mind to Satoguna, living in knowledge, happiness, then it balances our activity also. It does not take the mind to hyperactivity, does not lead to wandering mind, does not lead to obsession, does not lead to attachment. Now look at the tamas guna. It coming from Aiden. Good noise. So tamas guna is the material quality. You are inert. You act like as if I'm a matter. And that creates a lot of delusion, ambiguity, fantasy, doubt, laziness, opposing knowledge, all these steps. And they ultimately lead us to criminal activities. So it is not that I am lazy, yes. I am procrastinating, yes. I am living in fantasy, yes. We have to take care of these. We have to throw these qualities from our mind. Otherwise, in the long run, it will cause a lot of challenges in our life. You see, you have a blueprint for your life. Oh, I became upset and angry. Why should I become angry and upset? Let me think it over, change it to Satoguna. No, I said something nasty to my dad, so let me go back and say sorry. After understanding, not simply saying sorry. I understood, Dad. I understood, Mom. This is what happened to me. I will do my best. I will change myself. That is becoming a good person. Why shouldn't I say sorry? But after understanding. So how to balance this, to bring the mind to 90% satoguna, 7% rajas guna, and 3% tamas. Tamas guna is required because if tamas guna is not present, then you cannot have a sound sleep. So it is required. That is why we see in four-step relaxation, we lie down and we move the mind on the body. We try to make the mind totally, body totally calm and relaxed. When the body is totally relaxed, mind is focused, then we can have a sound sleep. Now, how to bring this mind that always lives in happiness and knowledge? So when you have a right knowledge, there is no problem. We had a right knowledge. So yesterday we reached home of AC. And if the address is wrong, we cannot reach. Are you getting it? Are you understanding, Hayden? I believe the moment you nod your head and I say, yes, you are understanding. So, now, the masters, our master says that we can change the mind to become a good person by Kriya Yoga. Kriya Yoga. What is Kriya Yoga? Let me first write down the word so that you can also write down Kriya Yoga. I have written it in the page number 7, or maybe. You can find out what is Kriya Yoga, Yoga Sutra 2.1 and 2.2. So what is Kriya Yoga? Kriya Yoga has three elements. What are the three elements? Discipline and education of the mind. That is the first. Write down Kriya Yoga. Kriya Yoga first is discipline and education of the mind. In Sanskrit, it is known as tapa. Second is self-study. In Sanskrit, it is known as swadhyaya. Third is surrender. Surrender or self, Ishwar pranighanani. In Sanskrit, it is known as Ishwar pranighan. I have written all the three. So we should also understand how the asana should be practiced to discipline the mind. Not only it helps the body, how the mantra can change our emotions and feeling. Like this, we have hundreds of practices in these three groups. We will not be going there into all those practices at this time. We will focus on the three qualities of a mind. 90% it should be done. So discipline and education of the mind is the first. Why we say discipline and education of the mind? What is discipline? Tell me, what is discipline?
It's to train your mind to do the right thing.
Yes, that is a wonderful definition. It's a train the mind means educate the mind. So if I have a habit of waking up very late, then what should I? I should educate my mind. How you educate through the mind? What are the things required so that you have, say, you have made a commitment to yourself that you are going to wake up 1 hour earlier than you used to do it. You say, for example, your habit is of waking up at 7. Now you educate the mind to wake up at 6. So their first thing to is clearly understood, educating the mind. But how to do that? So what yoga says, if you are too much tired, you wake up, you need more hours of sleep. Your mind is too much disturbed, wandering, you need more hours of sleep. So what should you do? What should be the discipline? Just before going to the bed, practice relaxation, practice nyasa, maybe practice mantra, and then fall into sleep. You do it for about 2 weeks, you will discover that now you don't need so many hours of sleep. One day it will happen, you will wake up early, you have more time to do the practice to become a good person. This is only one example. We will understand other examples as we move forward. So what happens when we practice Kriya Yoga, means all the three groups of practices. Why you wake up so late? Your dad says, and you get upset, you know, what should I do? I feel tired. I cannot wake up like this. That is one way of reacting. Other way is to look at myself. Yes, Dad, you are right. Let me work on it, and I will make sure that I will wake up early. I will not spend too much of time in sleeping, in oversleeping. What this knowledge is? This is the second group, self-study. I should focus on myself. If someone says, you are good, focus on yourself. Look at it. What goodness I have done. No, you are crazy. So let me look at myself. Don't start reacting to people. Self-study. You got it? Second group of practices is that, after all, there is the supreme power that is ruling all of us. So we should think about it. We should know more about it. And that is what is the third. So all the three groups of practices, what it does, it makes us a good person. It helps us to succeed in meditation. These are the two benefits. First benefit is it helps us to meditate rightly for deeper and longer hours. Why meditation? To know the real self. Why to know the real self? To become the best person in the world. And by these three groups of practices, it changes the mind to satoguna. So when you live in satoguna, you remove the suffering, you remove your anxiety, you remove your reaction, you change you transform your mind completely. It minimizes your suffering. You got it? It minimizes the suffering. It minimizes the suffering. So we started with mind. Then we said the entire world consists of three gunas. Whether your smartphone, whether your body, whether your mind, whether your intellect, everything consists of these three gunas. Without these three gunas, the world cannot exist. Then we came to the mind. We said all the three gunas are present in the mind. Got it? Then satoguna, rajoguna and tamoguna. So we have understood the satoguna is nothing but 90%. 90, if it is 90%, then what is 90% in satoguna? Knowledge and happiness. What is 7%? It is rajoguna, activity, action, overreaction, hyperactivity, strong likes and dislikes. So I have to balance it. It gives me an energy to be committed. So I will take the energy and redirect that energy for the knowledge and happiness. Then tamas guna is low lethargy, laziness, but also it helps us to sleep. So we cannot get rid of the tamo guna completely. And then we understand how to take the mind to the 90% sato guna. We understood kriya yoga. Kriya yoga has three elements: discipline and education of the mind. Second element is self-study. Third element is known as surrender. So take surrender as a positive attitude. I can say I belong to the world entirely. Air, I belong to you and you belong to me. Earth, I belong to you and you. I cannot exist without these five elements. Hence, I'm grateful to you. So when you are grateful, your mind changes. Internally, you have to do it mentally. I am grateful to both of you. You are giving me an opportunity to teach. I am blessed that I got good kids to teach. I think in that way. So when I think in that way, you see that? Then you start caring. The care, the compassion, the love, the peace comes into your mind. And when you start teaching with your caring, with compassionate mind, with clarity, it not only helps you, but it also helps me.